Hey guys, it's Friday, and I'm going to tell you a little bit of a story today. So, as some of you may know, I got my motorcycle license this summer. Something I've wanted to do for a very, very, very long time. Since before I was 16, probably, I just never did it. So this summer, though, I put a lot of serious thought into it, and I actually debated signing up for a couple of months. Almost every night I would go onto the website and I would fill out the registration and I would get almost done, and when it would come to the finalization part where I would just have to confirm, I would get nervous and I would just close my browser and that would be it until the next night, until I tried again. Kayla knew how much I wanted my motorcycle license and she was 100% supportive through the entire thing. She kept telling me to just sign up for it and just do it, but I was too nervous. She did admit to me, though, I guess, that she was nervous of me having a motorcycle, which I guess is 100% understandable. Who's not? So I guess probably after about a month of partially filling out this registration every night, I finally took that plunge and I hit the confirm. And soon later, I got a confirmation email giving me all the information I was going to need about the course, which was August 10th. At that time, it was well over a month away. Super excited. I was very nervous, but I was very, very excited. So the first thing I did after that was hit Facebook Marketplace. I started looking for a bike. I had no idea what style I wanted. I didn't know what style I liked. I'd probably only ever been on a dirt bike a couple of times in my life, never been on a motorcycle at all up until that point. So I was basically looking for something cheap, looking for the most affordable bike I could find. I just wanted something that I could putt around with and get used to this summer. And I happened across a 1984 Honda Magna 500. The gentleman, I believe, was in the military and he wasn't going to be able to use the bike for the summer, so he didn't want it to sit. He wanted somebody to get some use out of it. The bike was not inspected, but it was in good shape. He actually only wanted $500 for the bike, and he, believe it or not, took $425. So I contacted my father, and he agreed to give me a hand going to get it. So we rented a U-Haul trailer, and we went to Greenwood, me, him, and Malcolm, and met the gentleman. Seen the bike for the first time. I was even too nervous at that point to try to drive it onto the trailer, so my father did that for me. So we got it loaded up, we strapped it down, and we brought it home. We got it in the yard. And I parked it, and that was that. I came inside, and I probably looked out the window at it every 5 minutes for the next week. Until one day I had the courage to go and start it up. That was my first experience with that. So I started it up, and I think the first time I might have just let it go roll down the driveway and then back up. Very quickly, I was darting up my road and back down, getting used to driving a motorcycle, which I had never been on. Very quickly after that, I was going around the block, and it was probably about a week after I started driving it at all that I decided I was going to take the bike to get a new safety inspection on it. So I took the bike, which I did have insurance on at this point, I guess, but I hadn't taken my course yet. So me and the bike went across the mountain, and it was my first time on the bike going over 15 kilometers an hour at that point. So trying to hit the speed limit of 80 was a bit terrifying. So I come to a shop that somebody had recommended me, met the gentleman there, did not inform him that I didn't have a bike license yet. He inspected the bike. It honestly needed nothing. I paid $425 for the bike. I took it out. I got it inspected. It cost me nothing. The inspection was however much that was. Had a 2-year sticker on it. So I brought the bike home, and that was perfect. Now I literally just had to wait for August 10th to take my course. It was a 3-day course. It started on a Friday evening. Friday evening was a classroom portion, and the Saturday and Sunday were two full 8-hour days in a parking lot, all practical. I ended up with a little Honda CRF, I believe, 125. It was just a little dirt bike. It wasn't even a street bike. Going into the course, I was as nervous as I've ever been. I don't do well with big crowds of people. Sometimes even crowds of people that I know, like family, Christmas night at family gatherings can be a little overwhelming sometimes. So the thought of going to a course, learning something I had zero experience about, with a group of people who I didn't know. I didn't know if they were going to be experienced, if they've been riding motorcycles their whole life. It was a little nerve-wracking. I was very stressed out about that, but I stuck through it. I showed up Friday night, and I was one of the first ones in the room. I sat at the front of the class, basically so I didn't have to see anybody else. They could all sit behind me, and I could just stare at the teacher. People started coming in, and there were so many different people from all walks of life. There was even a family, a mother, father, and their son, who would all come to take the course together and get their motorcycle license as a family. And the wife had only ever been on a motorcycle once in a parking lot with her husband, and that did not end well. So yeah, I wasn't the only one there with no experience, so that was nice. It was a little bit comforting. Even the guys there who had experience were a little bit humbled, I think, by how much they didn't know and how much there was to learn about bike safety and a lot of little things that I don't think you would ever realize unless you took the course. Even if you've been driving your whole life, I think there are just little things that you don't think of on your own. So the practical course, or the practical portion of the course, was very fun. We put, I believe, almost 90 kilometers on our bikes within 2 days or 16 hours. So we rode a lot, we rode hard, we were tired and stiff, but through all the tired and stiffness, it was so much fun. The people I met there were great. I'm still in contact with a few of them to this day. After the course, we even went out on a few bike rides, which was amazing. I actually bought another bike towards the end of the summer. I'm not going to tell you what that is. I'm going to do a whole other video about that. I actually have a really good story, or a couple good stories about this bike. That I'll do in a later video. But basically, just the whole bike experience for me this summer was just incredible. The things I learned, the people I met, even the confidence that it gave me, just going and doing something that I was totally uncomfortable with. What I'm trying to say here, or today's message, is anything that you can do, you can do. Okay, guys? Like, really think about that. Anything you can do, you can do. And that, like, that's just think about that. All right, until next time, guys, stay crispy.